Brian?
Yep.
Hi, Brian. Nice to meet you.
Nice
Hi,
to meet
my
you
name
well.
Is Brian, too.
Cool, fantastic.
Yeah, we're two Brian. Tell us about yourself.
Okay, my name is Brian Collins. I am the lead designer from MishMashMachine. We're a small little game company here in Dallas, around the Dallas area, Plano area. And we are here today showcasing a mobile game called Raising Hell. And Raising Hell is a vertical jumper for mobile devices where you play as the devil trying to escape from hell freezing over.
Okay, and what is your history with being a game designer, or even in any developer for that matter?
I've been designing games probably for about 5 or 6 years now. Started off with board games, not too much of an artist, not too much of a programmer, so board games and card games are kind of easy to do solo. Me and a buddy went to the January Game Jam, January 2014, and I actually met up with a lot of these guys, and we produced a little prototype called Path. It's something we might try to bring back in the future, but it's right now it's just kind of sitting on the shelf, you know what I mean? But the process was so fun, and we really liked working with each other, we just decided to take that and, you know, change that into pretty much a company. So we've been working since January on a couple prototypes here and there, and then Raising Hell is going to be our first big release.
Okay, so what is your favorite part about being an indie developer, being in this industry?
I like the fact that when you start, you sit down for the first brainstorm, and you have just a blank piece of paper. And after several months and after talking to a bunch of people and this collaborative effort, you actually have something. So it's this creating something from nothing. And bringing fun and enjoyment to people, whereas, you know, a couple months ago, it was just, you know, words on the paper. So, I always like that creation process.
And what is the biggest challenge of being an indie developer?
Resources is probably always going to be. This is a second job for everybody in there, you know, within the company. So, you know, trying to make sure that we have enough time, we have enough resources, we are moving at a clip that is acceptable to us for when we want to get the product out of the door. But then also understanding that this is a side job and you know, we all have real world stuff and, you know, families to take care of and all that nice stuff. So it is, I think that's probably the biggest challenge.
Has there ever been a time where one of your game projects is on limbo, or you just need additional help, or you need a Kickstarter or something to sort of help boost its chance of getting out there?
I think that'll always happen. At least maybe with mine, it's always happening, because I always have, you know, lots of ideas, and we always want to make everything as big and as great as we can. And I think the philosophy for our company is that should kind of be the last resort. Like, we're really big into what we call sweat equity. So it's like, yeah, we might not be able to, you know, afford the 3D renders and you know, big sweeping vistas in our games quite yet, but we want to make sure that we put in the time and effort in it, because it is a labor of love. There have been times where we do want to kind of inject a little bit of cash, inject a little bit of resources, but I think that we, especially being really fledgling, we really want to test ourselves and really try to push ourselves. So we talked very early about kickstarting several different things, and I think that is good for some projects. But the projects we have right now, I don't think it would be beneficial.
And kickstarting is sort of a gamble, so you're never going to
exactly know
if you're going to succeed or not. And not succeeding may result in something that probably won't be good.
Yeah, and that's the other thing too, because there is a certain pride and ego. Not ego isn't the right word, but there is pride associated with your work. And, you know, if for whatever reason it does not get kickstarted, and, you know, the people that did participate in that did want to fund that, they will have that disappointment of, you know, well, I really wanted to do it, but then it just never got done. And we don't want to associate our company with that kind of disappointment. We have talked several times about it, and I think that it's not something I say we would necessarily always stray away from, but it's one of those deals where, you know, it'll be when it's necessary, then we'll actually use it. And when I mean by necessary, I mean it's like there's no way it's going to get done otherwise, pretty much. So.
Have you considered adventuring to other conventions besides the industry giants to kind of expand on your profile?
So we've been to a couple of the smaller ones here in Dallas. This is probably the biggest one at this point, you know, up until here. But like I said, we are still really new, and I personally love going to conferences. I've been to a couple GDCs, not with the company, but just kind of as a developer. And I do think it would be beneficial, not just to showcase our stuff, but to also just have conversations with different developers. I feel like the learning process is really important.
What's your thoughts on industry ties?
I love the fact that everyone's here. They're all so happy. They're also, you know, engaged and happy to see people. And that's always really something that you don't necessarily get with the big conventions. Is, you know, everyone's kind of there for their specific purpose. They have their blinders on and they're pretty much there to sell. Whereas, you know, here it's a more open atmosphere. It's a lot of back and forth, and you can get playtests and you playtest for them, and it's, you know, you get to showcase to people who genuinely want to interact with people. And you don't really get that a lot of places with a lot of, you know, the different conventions.
Well, I think that wraps things up. Thank you for your time.
Oh, thanks for having me.
You can follow MishMash Machine at MishMashMachine or go to www.mishmashmachine.com.